What's up everybody, this is DeanoGTO, and today we are looking at the Derelict Hunt for the 1965 Mustang. So, the Mustang, you find the chassis right here. So, the actual Derelict clue shows the river, that's how you find it. The river, and it also shows like a brief little glimpse of this little bridge here. And the circle is around like this area in general, like here. And the exact positioning for it is just like, it's in one of these car parking spaces right here. And initially I genuinely thought it was this one over here. Until like the little like pop-up came up over there showing me like, exactly where it was. I was looking at this here going, was that? But no, it's not. So let's get on to the actual parts for this vehicle. So there's 5 parts individually you have to collect. There is the actual chassis itself. There is, and then there's like 4 separate like just components in order to build up the car itself. So let's get into the first part. Okay, so whenever you find a derelict component, or you're in the general vicinity of a derelict component, what usually happens is you will hear this little radar bleeping noise. See, I have already found this derelict component, it's up there. I came back down here in order to show you like what it's what it actually does whenever you're in, within range of it. It's a lot about a lot when you actually find the other parts, because, well, they don't make it that easy. And you can kind of time it so you can pick it up while you're going past it, pretty much. So that's one part of 4 found. So let's get on to the next part. Okay, so the next component is actually the top left of the derelict components. You can see it just here. So this one here was relatively easy to find based on, yet again, the highway, which is the deep blue line, or dark blue, whatever you want to call it. So the crisscrossing in the motorway makes it relatively easy to find. So you basically go off of that. And as you can see here, I found the crisscrossing in the motorway. And we know it's not on the motorway directly, it's off to the side and up past the town. So that's basically how I found this here. I essentially just fast traveled to this and just drove up here and found this looks like the general area it should be in. So I can already see there's actually a token up there, if you can see that. Like a little spinning thing up there. So that's a token I found at least. And there is the actual derelict component there. So let's just see here. Going off previous experience with the last one, I'm going to guess you're going to have to ramp up this here. So, considering I can see a little dirt track, so, yep, there's a ramp right here. So, let's just try and get the ramp right. And there it is, nailed it. So, they also can be next to couches, based off the last couple I've done. So, that, I'm not sure exactly what that is, but probably like an engine or something. And that's that one found. So, let's go on to the last one. Okay, so now we're on to the last derelict component that we need to find. It is this one here, and yet again it's pretty easy to find based off of the motorway. So the motorway's shape makes it just pretty easy, if I'm being honest, because, well, it's got this like double road area here, and it's like slims down this area here, which kind of gives it away, as well as this road here. You can kind of just tell based off of those two things here that that's the general location. So I'm guessing it's going to be up in this general location here, based off of the way that it looks on the map. So let's just see here. So it's off to the left of this one here. Yeah. So this general area here is where I'm guessing it will be. Also, found a token right here where I was on the map. So yeah. So if you want to find that, that was relatively easy. I'm not really sure what the point of those is, but whatever. Let's see. Just gonna head up and around here. I've actually never been to this part of the map, to be honest. I think I may have sped through here at one point, but oh, it's not off-road. Did not realize that. So I've been using the dirt car, the off-roading car for this year because, well, the majority of the parts, oh, I'm in the right area. Do I see a blue thing? Not yet. Let's see. So where could this be at? I'm just looking at the higher up where he is now because I'm feeling really easy up there. Oh, got too far away, so where's this at? Is it be up on top of that? Is that? Oh wow, it is. Holy wow. How on earth do you get up there? So the clue about them being on higher ground is not wrong. Let's see, so oh, looks like there might be, is there a trail? No. Some like invisible walls in this map, it can be kind of annoying sometimes. Looks like I could be over there, but I'm not sure I can drive that way. What's up here? There you go. I feel like it's up here, but I'm not sure if I can actually drive up there. Maybe I have to jump off this. Let's see. So it's definitely over there on that diagram up there. And it does look like there's tracks up there. Did I miss a way up? I'm going to try and jump from here up this, so let's just see. It's probably not the right way of doing it, but whatever. And that worked pretty well. Also, a tip for slowing yourself down if you want to move too quick, just hold the square. Or not square button, but the handbrake button. Square on my controller. So, yeah, that's the last component. Relatively easy to find. Probably an easier way up there, but yeah. Oh, it was fun. So, I think that's it. I'm not sure what happens after you did that, but
to rebuild the 65 Mustang.
Oh, you had to return to the garage in order to build it. Yeah, let's do that now. Okay, so we're now back in the garage. We have all the derelict components. You can see the wheels, the what's the interior or the fenders, the engine, and the last part we can't actually see behind the screen. So let's
what
just
kind
see
of build
here.
You want for
so
this one?
Oh, so now I have to select
race
which
build?
Type. Race
with
build,
a drift
build, drag build, runner build, or off-road
is
build.
A setup that'll give you the grip and shocks you need to survive.
I feel like this thing off-road would be cool. I feel like it would be cool as a runner. Well, maybe not a runner, because I feel like it's a little too sporty to be a runner car. Runner cars I typically think of as being like four-door saloons or something. Let's see, destroy or restore as a drag build. Drag build I feel like it's a little too easy. I think drift build may be the one I go for. Race build, I'm pretty happy with my S2000 for now. I'm probably going to buy something a bit higher part in the near future. And if you're wondering like why I have like nearly 300,000 of the money currency in this game, the reason for that there is like this is I'm playing this year after the rebalance of the actual credit earning system in the game, so it's really easy to make money in this game. People are not exaggerating when they say it's really really easy. It's honestly kind of too easy. Like I haven't spent any credits on anything except fast travel, and I've only lost one side bet, and that's how much I have. So yeah, I'm gonna build this thing as a drift car because I kind of need a drift car for the phase of the game I'm in. So let's see what it actually looks like.
Look at that classic 65 Mustang. If that body doesn't
oh yeah,
heads,
you have 300 to
definitely
build.
Will.
Pretty good looking. I don't, unfortunately I do not have the ability to actually fully customize this thing because I haven't really done all the things you really need to do. Like I haven't done three jump activities with 2-star rating, I haven't defeated a roaming racer, haven't done that either. So yeah, this may take a while for me to actually build this thing properly, but yeah, nice to have as my first derelict vehicle. So next I'll probably try and do the 240Z, but hopefully sooner rather than later I will be able to actually build this thing up, but for now that's the way it's going to stay. So yeah, hopefully this has been helpful for you. So thanks for watching, I will see you in the next one.